So, hello, my name is Christina Papadimitriou.
So my name is Giannis Nicolaou, and I want to thank the organizers for inviting us for a lightning talk. Christine and I will present to you some of the findings we had for our journey in transforming an agile organization to scale. So during this journey, and most of you have been through this transformation now, you will face dilemmas. You will find situations where you don't know what is right or wrong, cases where bibliography or coaches or experts cannot tell you what's the right answer, and you need to make a decision. So what we will do now is share with you a few of these dilemmas we faced, what we decided to do, in the hope that you will also find that helpful.
So when we started the journey of using Agile for development process, we decided to have a pilot phase. In the first phase, we decided to go with two distributed teams. We were geographically separated and one local team. We ran this pilot phase for 5 months, 10 sprints, and after this period we decided that we would proceed with the creation of local teams. So, we have 15 Scrum teams around the world. We have them in 4 regions, and they're located in Europe and in the States. When we started with the creation of the teams, next slide please. we decided to have a dedicated product owner for each Scrum team. Later on, as we get more mature with the process, we decided to have one product owner for every 2 or 3 teams. Sometimes the features that each team was working on were in similar areas, some were in different areas. Because, as we mentioned, we have 15 teams, we have a group of product management where we have one head, and we have also a team of product managers, and they are the people who talk directly with our customers to understand the business needs. And then we have another group of product owners who are the people working closely with the Scrum team to analyze all the requirements and help the team deliver it. So this was how we decided to have the product owner inside the team.
Now for the Scrum Master role,
yes.
The question is, how many teams can a Scrum Master handle? So initially we went by the book, one Scrum Master, one team. After a while we realized that that doesn't scale very well when you have really a lot of teams. So we tried one Scrum Master with multiple teams. In some cases we went up to 3 teams. And then we also realized that doesn't work very well. And currently what we are doing is we have, again, one Scrum Master per team, but being a team member. And we are thinking about even rotating this role among the team members, not because we don't believe it's important. And this also ties very well with what was mentioned in an earlier presentation, that the Scrum Master is a servant leader of the team. And it's much better, instead of having one, having actually 5 or 6 servant leaders in each team. So it's close to this guest leadership that was mentioned in a presentation before.
Last but not least, the most important part is the Scrum team. So our Scrum teams are doing end-to-end feature development. The team is responsible to decide what kind of architecture they will use, what kind of technologies they are using. However, if they have any technicalities that they want to discuss with, we have a group of architects that they can consult. What is important is that the code ownership is owned by the team. So the team is responsible for delivering the feature with all the done criteria and all the quality metrics that we have decided. And this is how we approach the Scrum framework. What is important, I think, Giannis, we need to underline that, is that we tried things. There is no right and wrong. We did a retrospective, and then we decided how to adapt and try again. And as we evolve, we get more mature and we are more ready to try out things.
And we've been in this journey for now about 120 sprints of 2 weeks duration, which is roughly 5 years. And the outcome of all this is that all our actions and all our decisions make sense in retrospect. So our suggestion is to try things, see how they work, and then change again. And that's, I think, the whole purpose of being agile in the first place. So my name is Giannis Nicolaou.
I am Christina.
We are working for Atos, and thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you.
We're happy to take any questions.